Taiwan has detected the highest number of Chinese military aircraft around the self-ruled island this year. Taiwan's defense ministry said Friday 36 Chinese military aircraft were seen around the island in the past 24 hours, 13 of which crossed the median line of the Taiwan Strait. Now, that strait is the sensitive waterway that separates China from Taiwan. Six Chinese naval ships were also detected there. China is claiming the self-governed island as its own. It has vowed to unify Taiwan with the mainland using force if necessary. The United States continuing to push for a ceasefire deal in Gaza. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken says the gaps are narrowing in talks in Doha, but the main sticking points remain, with Hamas saying it will release hostages only as part of an agreement that would end the war, while Israel only wants to discuss a temporary pause. Ahead of his Friday visit to Israel, Blinken says he agreed with Egypt's foreign minister on gathering experts to discuss steps for increasing the flow of assistance into Gaza.
The teams are working every single day on this. As I said, there's still real challenges. We've closed the gaps, but there are still gaps. So I can't put a timeline on it. I can just say that we're committed to doing everything possible to reaching an agreement, and that work is ongoing.
A company co-founded by tech tycoon Elon Musk demonstrates the successful use of a brain chip implant, which enabled a paralyzed man to move computer chess pieces with his mind. Take a look.
Noland Arbaugh is playing this game of chess with his brain, using a chip implanted by Elon Musk's startup Neuralink.
I'd like to introduce you to the first ever user of the Neuralink device.
The company live-streamed the event on Wednesday. Arbaugh, in January, became the first patient to receive a Neuralink implant, which seeks to enable people to control a computer cursor or keyboard using only their thoughts. The 29-year-old was in a diving accident 8 years ago that left him paralyzed from the shoulders down.
Do you want to explain a little bit what's going on here?
Yeah, so I love playing chess, and so this is one of the things that y'all have enabled me to do, something that I wasn't able to really do much the last few years, especially not like this. I had to use like a mouse stick and stuff, but now it's all being done with my brain. If y'all can see the cursor moving around the screen, that's all me, y'all. It's pretty cool, huh?
Actually, can you pause the song just for the audio coming through? And that was also done with your brain?
Yep. It's all brain power up there.
Arbaugh said that while there was room for improvement with the new technology, it had already, quote, changed his life. Former program director for neural engineering at the U.S. National Institute of Health, Kip Ludwig, said what Neuralink showed was a, quote, good starting point, but not a, quote, breakthrough. Last month, Reuters reported that U.S. Food and Drug Administration inspectors found problems with record-keeping and quality controls for animal experiments at the firm. Those findings came less than a month after Neuralink said it was cleared to test its brain implants in humans. The company did not respond then to questions about the FDA inspection.
Despite growing tensions in the West Philippine Sea, Beijing and Manila's trade relations remain intact. Chinese ambassador to Manila Wang Xilian says China continues to be the Philippines' largest trading partner, with two-way trade hitting $40 billion last year.
The largest trading partner of the Philippines for 8 consecutive years, and investment in the Philippines has also maintained rapid growth, making it one of the largest sources of investments. Despite different national conditions and systems, we pursued similar development goals, complement each other's strengths, and have enormous potential for mutually beneficial cooperation.
Wang also highlighted Beijing's continued economic growth and his country's role in global development. Cambodia wants more Filipinos to teach English in their country as it aims to strengthen cooperation in education with Manila. More from Ara Perez.
Dorothy was earning 2,000 to 5,000 pesos monthly when she was still teaching at a private school in Iloilo province in the Philippines before deciding to transfer and teach in Cambodia in 2018. She now earns $900 or about 50,000 pesos a month.
Iba yung satisfaction kapag natuturuan mo yung mga bata. Yung experience to teach special kids. Sa Pinas kasi, para mahirap magturo sa special education. You need a lot of trainings and then kailangan talagang knowledgeable ka sa pag-handle ng mga sped kids. Dito, they give a lot of opportunities for special teachers. And then they have like a need talaga for special teachers.
Meantime, another Filipino teacher, Lovey, admits she only received formal training in teaching when she moved to Cambodia. She's now the principal and owner of Liberty International School in Phnom Penh, Cambodia.
They taught us how to deal with non-English speaking kids, animated ka din, and then all the visual aids. So we use visual aids. Mabilis silang mag-learn and mag-adjust.
The Philippine Embassy in Phnom Penh, Cambodia says more than half of the 5,000 to 7,000 OFWs here are private and international school teachers. And the country is still open to accept more Filipino teachers.
Say a Cambodian school, pwede siyang mag-direct hire ng up to 5 Filipinos. Naghahanap pa rin po sila ng mga teachers dito sa Cambodia. They want Filipino teachers to teach them English, but I would strongly recommend po that etong mga schools na ito or etong mga teachers who are looking for jobs here in Cambodia na pumunta po tayo sa DMW, sa Department of Migrant Workers, at meron pong mga recruitment agencies dun, mga legal na recruitment agencies, dun po sila magpunta. A lot of Cambodians have learned English from Filipinos during the UNTAC days, yung UN Transitional Authority in Cambodia. Marami po tayo mga Filipinos na pinadala, mga Filipino peacekeepers na pinadala dito sa Cambodia.
Private school teachers in Cambodia earn $600 to $2,400 monthly, about 33,000 to 134,000 pesos.
But aside from salary and benefits, teachers are attracted here in Cambodia because of the low cost of living and of its being time efficient, as heavy traffic is rare here.
Aside from English, teaching math and literacy is also a priority.
They are now mandating na lahat ng mga students kailangan ng pumasok ng primary school. I believe there was a time na hindi pa siya ganun ka widespread, parang hindi normal para sa kanila ang mag-aral ang mga bata. So you can expect na talagang na-disrupt ang education ng mga bata.
History and peace studies are also essential to the curriculum here.
Binababa nila dun sa level ng mga bata para ma-inculcate sa mga bata yung sense na kung wala kang peace, kung wala kang kapayapaan, walang progreso, di ba? Walang progreso ang mangyayari. So all the development and the progress that they are experiencing right now is a direct product of peace.
Amen.
Vice President and Deputy Secretary Sara Duterte visited some schools here in Cambodia as the Council Chairperson of the Southeast Asian Ministers of Education Organization in a bid to learn from the country and see what the Philippines can also offer in terms of boosting education quality. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News, Cambodia.